In front of the largest crowd in wrestling TV history, the focus of the industry since Thursday night for the over 41,000 at the Georgia Dome and the TV audience watching, was the announcement of the first Hogan vs. Goldberg match being put on TV as the main event title match for the promoted biggest Nitro in history. Hogan and Bischoff came out to open the show with Hogan saying that the match is not gonna happen because Goldberg doesn't deserve to be in the ring with him, and because WCW disrespected him by not notifying him in advance and putting the right offer on the table. Hogan addressed the Goldberg hometown crowd saying that because he's a fair man he's gonna give him a chance to earn the match, putting Goldberg against an NWO brother about to arrive who gave him a call after the announcement was made. With Raw last week winning by its largest margin in history headlined by a Kane vs. Austin title match, Hogan reportedly called Eric during the week with the suggestion of moving the scheduled dark match to a world title match in the television main event with a plan to top the previous week and bring the momentum back to WCW's side. WCW knowing the reaction in Atlanta on the night with the crowd chanting for Goldberg hours before entering the stadium, Nitro for the first time was built as Goldberg's show with highlights airing throughout of his winning streak milestone victories. With the NWO opponent yet to arrive, Buff Bagwell was shown outside in his first appearance since the injury on Thunder, with him set to address the crowd in a promo later. With all the expected arrivals, one who didn't show up on the night was Dennis Rodman. Rodman, who also no-showed the Chicago practice during the NBA Finals, was reportedly seen drunk at a concert the night before but is expected to appear on Sunday, as Page and Malone were out a few minutes from 9 p.m. for the final hype promo to the tag match. A week after drawing a record viewership, Undertaker opened Raw demanding a shot against Austin, as Austin was coming out to address the challenge to bring out Vince McMahon to stop it. Vince said that the inmates are attempting to run the asylum and only he decides if and when the title will be defended, announcing the fully loaded pay-per-view main event with Austin and Taker against Kane and Mankind with the number one contender announced in a segment later in the show, as Raw started in the lead with a 4.1 rating, which would also be its only quarter-hour win of the night. WCW took a commercial break at the top of the hour and then set the stage for the night with NWO Hollywood waiting outside the stadium, as Scott Hall arrived in his first TV appearance since March saying that he's gonna take Goldberg to school later tonight. Next on Raw was Shamrock vs. Jarrett going 5 minutes, ending with a surprise finish of former King of the Ring winner Mabel making his return to attack Shamrock and set up a match between them for later. At the same time WCW went ahead with Jericho vs. Dragon and Chavo vs. Swinger jumping over 500,000 viewers, and from that point WCW stayed in the lead for the rest of the night. Ric Flair, who at one point was talked about potentially returning tonight to reform the Horsemen, did a media interview yesterday in the Atlanta area, talking about the WCW lawsuit and his current relationship with the company. Flair said that he drew the line after being vented on one too many times, referring in part to a bad relationship with Eric Bischoff, including what Flair saw as a personal shot with Bischoff only mentioning Hogan, Savage and Piper as the historically big money-drawing stars in the company while Flair was sitting in the room. Flair said that for the last 20 years he was selling out every arena in the Southeast United States, and stood the test of time, remaining one of the biggest TV draws in the industry to this day, with the article ending with Flair saying that he would consider returning to WCW only under the right circumstances. Next on Nitro was a different segment to anything else on the night, as Marcus Bagwell made his TV return for the first time since a near tragedy in April that saw him laying in the ring temporarily paralyzed, coming out to a massive ovation from the crowd. Bagwell said that he now has a different outlook after nearly losing his life twice, thanking his mom and the crowd for their support on his way to recovery, with WCW continuing to climb, jumping to a 4.7 rating. Raw closed out the first hour dropping to a show low 3.4 rating, largely due to what was going on at the same time on TNT, having Terry Funk vs. Steel O' Brown going 4 minutes with D'Lo going over after Godfather's interference, bringing out Taker post-match to lay them all out as Vince McMahon walked to the ring moments later for the number one contender announcement, bringing out Mankind, Kane and Taker with the reveal segment crossing over the top of the hour. Bill Goldberg came out for the first time on the night to a huge ovation from the massive hometown crowd, with WCW putting on another big potential pay-per-view headliner in the first ever Scott Hall vs. Goldberg match before even getting to Hogan, as Hall made his in-ring TV return with his first match since March. Hall taunted Goldberg throughout the match, with the stadium exploding for every Goldberg comeback, going 6 minutes in Goldberg's longest TV match to date against the highest profile opponent in his career, ending with Page and Malone taking out NWO Hollywood, with Goldberg going over to a huge pop to officially set up Hogan vs. Goldberg in less than an hour, with the match picking up big with over 800,000 viewers to a 5.4 rating, WCW's highest rated segment in almost 3 months. Vince was in the ring with the three contenders to open the second hour, with him making the case for each one getting the title shot. McMahon put over Mick Foley for his performance in the Hell in the Cell match last Sunday, thanking him for everything he has done for the company before going over to Kane and Taker, ending up with him booking a three-way for the main event tonight, with the segment bouncing Raw back over 900,000 viewers to a 4.2 rating. In a quarter which also included the second Brawl for All fight of the night with Draws vs. Hawk, as for the second week the two fights did strong numbers, although this week boosted by following the big star power segments. With the hype for the Goldberg-Hogan match now officially rolling throughout the hour, Mark Mero and Jacqueline came out for a promo on Sable. Jacqueline, in her first promo since joining Mero, took shots at Sable to bring her out, setting up a bikini contest for Fully Loaded as one of the selling points of the pay-per-view. With the record crowd and all the talk surrounding the Nitro Georgia Dome, the TV show leading up to the Bash at the Beach pay-per-view ended up almost completely overshadowing it, but on Sunday all the focus will be on the big crossover tag match, with massive mainstream coverage expected on the show for Hogan and Rodman against Page and Malone, targeted by WCW and cable companies to do around the highest selling pay-per-views in history. Page in the final match before the show went over Jim Neidhart in a quarter which also featured Giant vs. Duggan. Raw's most talked about segment of the night came at 10:35, just before the main event, as DX, who hyped a surprise throughout the show with them not seen all day in the building, came out with a Nation parody along with Jason Sensation as Owen Hart. The segment inspired by last year's one of the most memorable and controversial segments with the NWO doing a Horseman parody, saw JR mentioning that Rock and Owen Hart had the night off and are currently in Miami and Calgary as to give them an out for not interrupting it, a key reason for the major heat stemming from the NWO Horseman segment with Flair and Anderson backstage and not booked to come out and respond to the NWO during the skit. DX did a comedy impersonation of each member of the Nation with the segment gaining over 600,000 viewers to Raw's peak of the night 4.8 rating. The Wolfpac came out to a big reaction for the final match before the main event, with Sting and Luger going over the flock in less than a minute to retain the tag belts. Moments later, Goldberg made his walk to the ring 20 minutes from the top of the hour before the final commercial break, as the Georgia Dome was buzzing with the match minutes away. Raw's final quarter going head-to-head against the highest viewership to ever watch wrestling on cable television, first saw Ken Shamrock take on Mabel in another King of the Ring match between the winners of the 95 and 98 tournaments, while moments later Vince McMahon and Steve Austin came out on commentary for the three-way main event. With Mankind and Kane in the ring, Undertaker didn't show up, with McMahon ordering the match to start as a singles match, ending up with a big swerve of Taker revealed under the Kane mask to set up the planned title match against Austin for SummerSlam in 8 weeks. Even with Raw having major star power out for the main event, the final quarter going against Goldberg vs. Hogan saw the show dropping over a million viewers to a 3.8 rating, with the gap between the shows of 3.1 rating points during the last 15 minutes the largest in history, as Raw dropped from last week's peak to a 4 rating, losing the night for the first time since April 20. After 3 hours of one of the best hype jobs in wrestling history, Goldberg and Hogan came out with 15 minutes to go to one of the hottest atmospheres the business has ever seen, with the stadium ready to erupt for Goldberg's title win. The decision to put the match on TV instead of building it to potentially a peak pay-per-view number was defended by Bischoff, saying that WCW was a TV company first, along with it being the perfect timing on the night to create an all-time memorable moment in the new megastar of the industry. Hogan and Goldberg went 8 minutes with the match shattering every all-time Monday Night Wars and cable TV record, jumping huge with over 1.8 million viewers to an all-time record 6.9 rating, breaking the record set by Savage vs. Hogan on April 20, with the final minute of the match ending up one of the biggest spectacles of all time with the crowd explosion for Goldberg winning his first WCW title, up there with anything in wrestling history, as on the night for anyone watching in the stadium or on television, Bill Goldberg 9 months after his debut was the biggest star in the business, with WCW hoping to take the momentum forward, winning the night by a wide margin with a 4.9 rating.